So let's talk about the 1 million rep threshold. What the heck is the 1 million rep threshold? All right, well, here's the story. I'm meeting with a very intelligent physical therapist a couple years ago about my dad's knees. He's telling me that my dad going forward should be thinking about how he lives his daily life. And I said, can you be more specific? And this guy says, if you have a choice between the elevator and the stairs, always take the elevator. Now, I'm in the fitness industry and I'm big on non-exercise activity. I like the idea of people getting more movement throughout their day, whether it be walking or taking the stairs or say parking further away from the grocery store than they need to get some extra work in. He's telling me, be careful of that advice simply because the amount of reps that it's going to place on your joints. Your joints have a span of life. Everybody's different. Everyone, depending on what they do with their body, but there's a threshold that your joint has. And it made me think a lot. I did some research on it. I never found any data on the 1 million rep threshold, but it did make me think about exercise selection, exercise volume, weighing out the risk to reward on things that I do and the things I suggest that my clients do, because it does add up. The reps add up, the volume adds up, and depending on the person's childhood, their choices of activities throughout their life, their athletic endeavors throughout their life, either in your 40s, they're in their 50s, they're in their 60s, 70s, you have to be careful on the prescription you give people depending on what they've done in the past and their current state of health. So think about that. How many reps might you have on your joints, and how will that affect your pain, injury potential, preventing injury, the volume, the load you place on your joints, the exercise selection, the repetitions? These things all matter when you're creating your own exercise program or you're creating it for someone else. How many reps before something may go wrong? Before that knee replacement, right? Before that Achilles rupture, before that pec tear, before that biceps tear, before that patella tendon rupture, but you know, your, you know, disc rupture, right? Like any of these things happen, that rarely happens just randomly. There's usually a load that's been placed on the joint or a disc or a muscle tissue repetitively with a certain amount of volume that creates the injury. So think about that when you're training yourself. Weigh out the risk to reward on exercise selection or modalities or what you're doing in your life, because it all adds up and it can have a positive or negative effect on your body that could be crucial, could put a lot of money, take a lot of money out of your pocket, a lot of time away from the things you love, depending on the things that you choose to do. So there's the 1 million rep threshold analogy. And I hope it makes you think a little bit about your own training program, or if you're a trainer or a coach, what are you doing to your own clients? How are you positively or negatively affecting their results? All right, till the next one. Bye-bye.